Hi everyone and welcome. When people are accessing your public-facing applications, it's essential to know who they are and continually verify their online identity while ensuring their personal information and privacy remain safeguarded, allowing your application to extend trust and grant them access. This is where Microsoft Entra External ID can help. My name is Siobhan Power.
And my name is Yola Always. We are product managers with the Microsoft Identity Product Group. And today we are here to talk about Microsoft Entra External ID, our custom identity and access management platform.
Microsoft Entra External ID is a solution designed to offer authentication and authorization for your customers and business consumers when they access your applications. In the identity industry, this solution is known as Customer Identity Access Management, or in short, CIAM. The C in CIAM can refer to individual consumers or citizens, or business customers like suppliers or vendors, or any other set of individuals outside your organization. Microsoft Entra External ID is an essential platform for businesses, public service agencies, healthcare providers, financial institutions, retailers, or any organization. It simplifies adding features such as self-service registration, customized sign-in, and customer account management to your applications and APIs. Users can bring their own identities to sign into your applications like email and password, email and one-time passcode, or identities from corporate or government issued to social identity providers like Google or Facebook. Regardless of how you onboard your users, you can manage their identity through self-service sign-up, profile edit, account recovery, and progressively getting to know your customer better, allowing you to personalize and secure their application experience. Microsoft Entra Conditional Access and Identity Protection safeguard the identities with real-time risk assessments that determine the necessary actions to protect their identity, such as requiring multi-factor authentication or blocking access altogether, ensuring that only legitimate users can access your application. Role-based access control allows you to grant users the precise access they need to fulfill their duties within your application. Sign-in logs offer a comprehensive record of each sign-in attempt, enabling you to monitor for unauthorized access attempts, identify potential security breaches, and understand user behavior. Let us share some of the most common scenarios to help explain how Microsoft Entra External ID functions. Let me hand you over to Yo, who will show you how a fictitious grocery store, Woodgrove, uses Microsoft Entra External ID to provide access for their customers to their online retail website.
Emily, a customer of Woodgrove Groceries, wants to order some items. She goes to woodgrovedemo.com. Customers wishing to add items to the shopping cart are required to sign in using their Woodgrove online account. Therefore, Emily selects the sign-in button, which will take her to the Microsoft Entra External ID sign-in page. The page is fully customized with the Woodgrove brand and blends seamlessly into their application's look and feel. The domain name that appears in the web address bar is an extension of the Woodgrove domain name, and customers can associate the signing experience with the Woodgrove brand. The header logo, the banner logo, the title, buttons, and the background image are all customized. Some of the labels have been modified and localized to accommodate Woodgrove business needs. Customers can sign in with their email and password or create a new account. The sign-in text appears with some guidance for customers, and users can also sign in with their social account like Google and Facebook. The footer contains links to the Woodgrove Term of Use and privacy policies. To create a new account, Emily selects the No Account, Create One option. She enters her email address and selects Next. At this point, Microsoft Entra ID sends a verification code to the email she entered. The email that appears now on the screen is the one sent to Emily. This email is fully customized to the Woodgrove branding needs. To continue, she enters the verification code she received. To create a new account, Emily needs to supply certain details like display name and password. But before Emily starts filling out the form, you should notice that the country is pre-selected, Spain. And also a promo code was generated for Emily. Woodgrove added their own business logic through Microsoft Entra External ID configuration to fetch these attributes from their online internal systems. Additionally, it's worth noting that the registration form accommodates a variety of user interface input elements, including text fields, checkboxes, and radio buttons. Emily enters the password and re-enters the password. Then a display name. She skips the country and enters an incorrect city, Berlin. You will see soon how this is handled. For the special diet, she enters eggs. So Woodward will warn Emily about product that contains eggs. She accepts the Woodward MFUs and privacy policies. Please note that the special diet, the promo code, and the Woodgrove policies are custom user attributes added to the sign-up page as defined by Woodgrove. Finally, Emily selects the next button to create the Woodgrove account. An error message appears. It says that Woodgrove does not operate in this city. This input validation is done by using custom logic Woodgrove configure that validates the city name against a list of cities and countries Woodgrove compiled. Since Berlin is a city in Germany and not in Spain, it returns an error message. Emily corrects the city to Madrid and tries to complete the registration. Great! The sign-up is successfully completed and her display name appears in the header. Now Emily has the option to add items to the shopping cart. And since eggs allergy was specified, a warning appears next to the eggs.
Meanwhile, Edward, another new customer of Woodgrove's, is bothered by having to create a new online identity. He wants to sign in with his Facebook account. From the Woodgrove groceries, he selects the sign-in button. Then on the sign-in page, he selects the Facebook sign-in option. He logs in with his Facebook account. Next, he will be asked by Facebook to consent to share certain information with the Woodgrove application, such as display name and email address. The first time he signs in, he completes the registration by providing additional information that is required by Woodgrove. Now, Edward can continue shopping and proceed to the checkout. But wait a second, what if Edward needs to update his shipping address or city? To do so, he selects the profile icon from the header. The profile page shows the user profile attributes along with other options. To edit the profile, he selects the Edit Your Profile button. Woodgrove requires users to sign in with multi-factor authentication. Since Edward has not signed in with MFA, he selects the Sign In button. On the Sign In page, Edward enters his phone number. He can also choose other options to verify his identity, like email address. Next, he enters the verification code he received to his phone. As demonstrated, Edward enjoys a convenient sign-in experience with minimal authentication steps, like sign-in with Facebook. However, upon risky action, such as when he attempted to update his profile, Woodgrove prompts for additional credentials such as MFA. After Edward signed in with MFA, he will be redirected back to the profile page, and now he has the option to edit his profile.
Do you remember Emily? Well, she now wants to listen to some music provided by the Woodgrove Music Service. She launches the Woodgrove Music application installed on her phone. The homepage renders some songs she can listen to. To start listening, she needs to be registered to the service and signed in. Therefore, she selects the login button. The sign-in functionality is seamlessly integrated into the Woodgrove Music application's look and feel. The login form is an overlay UI element inside the application. Users don't need to leave the application to sign in, and has no pop-ups or redirections. Everything is inside the application. Users have the option to sign up or reset their password. Since Emily already has an account, she enters her email address and password and signed in. And she's ready to start listening to the music.
We demonstrated some of the capabilities of Microsoft Entra External ID, our customer identity and access management platform. Microsoft Entra External ID provides an excellent customer experience that drives your brand loyalty and trust. It acts as a secure front door to your application, allowing you to focus on building an application and digital experience without worrying about managing identities.
All these amazing features are available to try out with our new free trial. To discover the latest updates, developer content, and resources for Micro Entra externally, please check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching this video, hope you enjoyed, and see you in the next one.